As a lifelong punter, he'll always say you need some luck. But it was a feeling about an absolute certainty that began Kenny Callender's remarkable career.
The first moment I walked in the newspaper door, I knew that this was me, this is what I wanted to do, and like the excitement, the hum of the place, and I thought it was great. And pretty much the same at the race course. The first time I went on the race course, there was bookies everywhere, people running everywhere, colour.
Racing 40 years ago was big news, and good young reporters shadowed the headliners. Ken quickly learnt to write without fear, stick with facts, and be sure to entertain.
I think the four-year cadetship you do as a newspaper, particularly in those days, was exceptionally thorough. And you carry that on to, you know, I carry that on today. Things I learnt then you still fall back on. But the entertaining factor, look, I used to like to think people are going to turn it off if you don't at least sound good. It's like telling a story in a bar. Blokes will drink with someone else if you're boring.
Okay, I better go through the prices because the dogs are getting down behind the boxes. Right, we have got a few 66 to 1.
Forthright, correct and fun, but never boring.
A Pizza Hut stuffed super supreme.
4 decades on, Ken Callender is part of that same race day atmosphere that intoxicated him as a youth. A Billy Birmingham enshrined sporting icon.
By crap, John, you're not wrong. I think he's a sensational prospect, this horse.
When he came out, my kids were sort of in the age range about 10 to 15, and all of them knew the Billy Birmingham tape off by heart, you know.
Did they really? All your boys?
All the boys knew how to say, 66 to 1 and Sunshine Sally.
Ken's career on this network began 30 years ago. Luck played no part beyond a place on a list of hopefuls.
He sat down at the set, he looked at the camera and just launched into a spiel with such confidence and poise that all of us, you know, on the set that day, the floor crew, the director, everybody in the control room were stunned. I doubt there has ever been a more confident audition in Australian television history. He was just a natural.
But I thought, you know, this is a chance, this is what I want to do, so, you know, it's like you got to aim up, know how to go, and thank God they kept employing me.
Righto, that's all at the moment from the racing section on the World of Sport.
The Callender role expanded with Nine's commitment to racing. When Wide World of Sports began to go trackside, Ken and his tote board were an act in themselves. Viewers could identify with the ever-cheerful character who backed his own tips.
Did you find it tough sometimes to raise a smile to camera after you'd had a big loss?
Oh, yeah. A couple of times. Oh, gee whiz, yeah. I can remember I was on a horse called Jericho Land at Rose Hill one day many years ago, and he got beaten the very last bound, and John Tapp said, it's a photo. Ken, he said, down to you. He said, I don't know what's won this. I said, John, I do.
Whether talking through his kick or pushing the cause of common sense, you'll know where Ken Callender stands.
But the people who go racing pay their money and they don't want a flash-looking jockey coming down the outside and telling them that when every other jockey tells them it's no good.
I'm employed to give an honest opinion. And I think the best analogy is if you had a theatre critic and he said every movie that he saw was terrific, who'd take any notice of him? Whereas I think if I'm honest and say that that was a bad ride, this was a good ride, at least, you know, people will accept that opinion, so at least he's saying as it is. And I always feel I don't owe anything to the administrators or whatever, but I can tell you a few jockeys get a bit touchy when you criticise them.
But Diatribe is clear, Diatribe in front of Prabhupada, Diatribe!
Jim Cassidy has been on the end of a few Callender sprays, so to speak. Like them or not, he says, you have to respect the man.
Whether it's myself or Darren Beedman, Corey Brown or whoever, he's the first one to praise jockeys. And even maybe when he hasn't backed the right one, he'll still be critical. And look, we need people like Kenny Callender in racing. It makes jockeys lift their game when you know you've ridden a bad one. I've copped plenty from Ken, but I've had broad shoulders. I've been able to rise above it and still come out and punch winners home. And that's what it's all about.
And how many female jockeys still talk to you?
Probably Vernie Cooper. I think she's a good rider, the queen of the present crop. And Robin Freeman, she's a young apprentice now, but I've had a go at a few of them over the years. Linda Jones, she's still a friend of mine. She was one of the original female jockeys, but I criticised a couple of them at times.
Ken Callender!
For a get square, all those angry jockeys only had to look at Ken's cameo acting efforts.
Did you take the numbers 8, 32, 4, 9, 6 and 69 in the Superfecta?
Yes, I did.
Awful as they were, there was a very real message for everyone in the public eye.
Well, if you can't laugh at yourself, I don't think, not only in broadcasting, I think in life, you haven't got much hope. You know, if you take yourself too seriously, someone else won't, and you're in for a fall. But I'm a lucky
man. He is skilled at writing, broadcasting, and punting, and has worked equally hard at all three.
Like, I'm lucky, I've got videos and computers and things that give me shortcuts. But you ask the average punter in the pub, Tim, and you'd be surprised how much he knows about racing. You know, they're pretty keen. But the people who just go in there and, you know, throw their money about, they've got to lose.
He's lived on his wits and done well. Ken Callender has 35 years of marriage, 4 grown sons, and much to do beyond Channel 9's exit from racing. His Daily Telegraph columns will continue to reflect his philosophy, to be accurate, honest, and entertaining.
I think Channel 9 do sports broadcasting better than anybody else, and if Channel 9 are giving it away, I think it's time that I did. I'd rather go out on top. I'd rather not be an old bloke hanging on looking for extra jobs somewhere, and I've enjoyed it all. It's been sensational.